We're going to talk tonight about another matter of the home, and that is integrity in the home. Integrity in the home. Let's be reminded, I know you've had a lesson on this, that it is not man that designed the home or originated the home, it's God. God created man in Genesis chapter 2 and verse 7. God formed man from the dust of the ground, breathed in his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul. Wouldn't you like to have been there? Wouldn't you like to have seen that? But more than that, he opened Adam's side and took a rib out and made Eve. Wouldn't that have been a wonderful thing to see? That'd be an amazing event to see a man made out of dust and a woman made out of a rib. And just trying to visualize that is very, very hard. But God made the man and he made the woman, and he designed the home to operate a certain way. And that's what we want to talk about tonight. We're going to talk about the home operating with integrity. We're going to be talking about integrity. I like that word, integrity. This is a much needed word in our society today, is integrity. And we're going to talk about integrity in the home. But we're not going to talk about integrity in any home. We're going to talk about your home. Your home needs integrity. God has designed the home to have integrity. Now, integrity has a definition. And that definition is honesty, moral uprightness, a high standard of morality, a standard of morality. Uprightness, righteousness, that's what integrity is. We need to have a more high moral standard in our home. We need to be honest in our home. We need to be people of integrity in our home. It's a quality. And by the way, integrity in the home, that's right down the Bible's line. The Bible teaches integrity from the front cover all the way to the back cover. It teaches integrity. So this is definitely a Bible subject. And so integrity in the home is something integrity is what we need in our communities. Integrity is what we need in politics. Integrity is what we need in our schools. Integrity is what we need in our communities, and certainly, we need integrity in our homes where we associate with those that we love the most. And we need that integrity, and that's what we're going to be talking about. We need moral uprightness. We need moral principles. We need to be honest in our homes. Having integrity is how you get to heaven. No person without integrity will get to heaven. You believe that? I believe that. So let's study this matter of integrity in the home. Now, there's a starting place. There's a foundation for integrity. Where do we start in discussing this matter? Well, we start where the foundation is. And the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 3 and verse 11 that there's no foundation that can be laid than that which is laid, even Jesus Christ. And we're going to talk about integrity, high moral standards, and righteous standing. We need to start at the beginning place, and that starting place is Christ. I want to invite you to turn to your Bibles in 1 Peter chapter 2, and let's start at the beginning place as we talk about integrity. We need to turn to the Bible. You don't need to turn to some educational system or some institution. We need to turn to the Bible, and we need to have our lives standing on the surest foundation in all of the world, and that foundation is Christ. You know what's wrong with our society? You know why people's lives are falling apart? Why their homes are falling apart? Because they're not on the foundation of Christ. They have no foundation. They don't have a moral standard. They don't know what uprightness is. And so they're just making it up as they go along. We're not doing that. As Christians, we're not making it up as we go along. We're following Jesus Christ. Look at this passage of 1 Peter 2, verse 21. For even hereunto were ye called, because Christ also suffered for us, leaving us an example that we should follow in his steps. Now, who did he leave an example to? Well, he left an example to Christians. But let's be more specific than that. He left an example to every father. He left an example to every mother. He left an example to every child, every grandparent, every aunt, every uncle. He left an example for every cousin to follow. And so we want integrity in the home, and it starts with Christ. Now, he's left us an example. When I was in elementary school, above the chalkboard, they had the ABCs. They had capital A, little A, big B, little B, and they were perfect. And so you as a little kid, a little first grader or second grader, you try to copy that as carefully as you could to imitate that. That's what Christ is. Christ is our example. He's our perfect example. And we're trying to imitate him the best that we can. And so he is our example to follow. He's the example for everyone. Not athletes. That's not your example. Not celebrities, that's not your example. Not somebody who plays in a musical band or entertains or is some comedian. That's not our example to follow. It's Jesus Christ. He's left us an example that we should follow in his steps. Look at verse 22. Who did no sin, he was morally upright, righteous from the beginning to end. Who did no sin, neither was guile found in his mouth. If you have a New King James Version, it says neither deceit was found in his mouth. What is guile? That's deceiving. And so we don't need that. Dad, you don't need to be deceiving anybody in your home. You don't need to be deceiving the boss. You don't need to call in and say, I'm sick today, I can't come in, and then go play golf. There was no deceit in the mouth of Christ, and there doesn't need to be any deceit in the mouth of the father or the mother. You don't need to be trying to deceive your spouse or deceive your children. We need integrity in the home. That's what we're talking about tonight. We're talking about your home. We're not talking about some random home out here in the Tarrant County or Fort Worth or Burleson or Joshua, we're talking about your home. Well, you need integrity in your home. And to have integrity, you've got to follow Christ. And to follow Christ, you try to eliminate and eradicate sin from your life and certainly deceit from your speech. We don't need parents deceiving one another. We don't need the parents deceiving their children. And we don't need children deceiving their parents. And that's what that's all about. And so we're talking about integrity, and we're starting at the starting place. Then notice verse 23. Who, that's Christ, when he was reviled, reviled not again. That's a person of integrity. They called him names. They called him Beelzebub. But he didn't answer back in ugly, rude terms. He didn't do that. When someone in your house may get angry and say something ugly, you don't have a return for that. Listen, we're not in the payback business. We're not here to pay somebody back. Someone insults.